بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم نحمدہ و نصلی علی رسول الکریم اما بعد We should make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given us tawfiq to see so many days of the month Mubarak Ramadan, to witness these Mubarak Layali nights. If one really knew the value of Akhirat, knew the value of Allah, knew the value of Deen, then we would have remained in prostration and sajda our entire lives. There are certain farishtas which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created in ruku, certain in sajda. They will remain like that till qiyamah. لَمْ يَرْفَعُوا رُوسَهُمْ مُنْذُ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ From the time Allah created them, they were in these positions. إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Till judgment day. Then Allah will give them ijazat and permission to lift their heads. When they will lift their foreheads for the first time, they will say, سُبْحَانَكَ مَا عَبَدْنَاكَ حَقَّ عِبَادَتِكَ O Allah, all praise is to you. We have not worshipped you how we should have worshipped you. So many thousands of years in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will acknowledge they have not worshipped Allah how they're supposed to. Farishtas are not created. The malaika are not created for hisab. There's no hisab kitab for them. What about this insan who has been created and his accountability will be taken? So this time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, we need to utilize it properly, we need to value it. We need to make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the ni'mah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. His iman, a simple thing like iman. لا تقوم الساعة حتى لا يقال في الأرض الله الله Qiyamah will not happen until there is not a single person saying the word Allah, Allah. That is you and me. That is our value. Means the entire solar system, the earth, everything that is in existence, this world is running on one believer. Can we imagine any worldly system run on that? Let's take one example. Cruise ship. And the Symphony of Seas is a cruise ship. It's one of the biggest cruise ships in the ocean. It can take 6,680 passengers. 22 restaurants, 42 lounges, ice rings, zip line, etc. One passenger on that ship, will they rent that entire structure? No. Why? Because that one person is not valuable. But let's say the owner of the company that owns that ship, he wants to take that ship somewhere. It'll run. Why? Because he has value. Because we have value, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is letting this entire solar system run because of our iman. The kuffar in akhirat, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ كُفَّارٌ فَلَيْ يُقَبَلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمْ مِلْءُ الْأَرْضِ ذَهَبًا They will wish even if they had to give the entire earth filled with gold. وَلَوْ افْتَدَى بِهِ That will not be accepted from them. A person says, Subhanallah, غُرِسَتْ لَهُ شَجَرَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ A tree is planted in Jannah, just the bark alone is made of gold. مَا فِي الْجَنَّةِ الشَّجَرَ إِلَّا وَسَقُوا مِنْ ذَهَبٍ That the bark is made of pure gold, and that's the goal of Jannah. We say 24 karat, what about the goal in Akhirat? إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ لَشَجَرَ يَسِيرُ رَاقِي فِي ذِلِّهَا مِئَةَ سَنَةَ لَا يَقْطَعُهَا A person will ride for 100 years, he will not reach the end of the shade of the tree of Jannah. Can we imagine how much gold will be in that one subhanallah? Let us say one subhanallah now. Let us make a niyyah tonight, we will read Qulhu Allah three times. We get the reward of the whole Quran. Now that you said subhanallah, let's just evaluate it. Currently in the world, if we are to value just the amount of gold in the world, they say 244 tons of gold has been discovered to date. If we have to fill all the gold that has been discovered and yet to be discovered, it'll make a cube 28 meters wide on all sides. Or to understand it more simply, it will fill 3 to 4 Olympic size pools. 190,000 tons have been mined. which is 77% of the world's gold reserves. The balance which they expect over the next 20 years will be depleted. That's the total amount of reserves of gold on Earth, 3 Olympic-sized swimming pools. A person who said Subhanallah now once, not counting it, multiply 10, 700 times, 490 million times, etc. Let's just go by one reward. The speed of a horse is an average fast horse, 80 kilometers an hour. If we calculate 100 years, 876,000 hours, which comes to about 70 million kilometers. 70 million kilometers. The diameter of the Earth is 12,700 kilometers. 12,700. How big, if we were to calculate 70 million compared to 12,700, approximately how big will be that one tree and how much gold will that be compared to what is currently on Earth, complete reserves? This is just for one Subhanallah. Now, if you read the three quls, you will get one Quran reward. If it is the night of Laylatul-Qadr, it's multiplied by 1,000 months times 30 days. So every night literally is 30,000 nights of reward. If you made one khatam on the night of Laylatul-Qadr, you'll get a reward of 30,000 khatams. Can we actually evaluate or understand? A farmer seen the entourage of Sulaymaan alayhi salam. He said, Subhanallah wa hamdi laqad utiya ala Dawood mulkan azima. That Sulaymaan alayhi salam has been given a great kingdom. Jibreel alayhi salam came to Sulaymaan alayhi salam, told him, give glad tidings to your follower who has said these statements and tell him. Sulaymaan alayhi salam went and narrated to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a message. Wa izzati wa jalali laqawluka. By the qasam of Allah, your speech, Subhanallah wa bihamdi, khayrum mimma utiya alu Dawood. Whatever Sulaymaan alayhi salam in his entire kingdom has been granted is more valuable. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. Just as one Subhanallah. So we have not really understood the value of akhirat. If somebody comes with a deal with you to say, you know what, for every gram of sand you give me, I'll give you gold. So who's foolish and who's fooled? So if a person is so wise that he can scam a person, that for every gram of gold, he will get sand. He's a very good scammer. And the person who scammed is a foolish person. So Sahaba were wise because they sell dunya, which was valueless, sand, for something which was valuable, akhirat. We are foolish. We are sacrificing the gold of akhirat, the value of akhirat, Allah, amal, in exchange for dunya. So you say Sahaba were wise. Sahaba understood akhirat. So this iman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, it is a very valuable commodity. Every subhanallah, every tasbih, every dhikr, every amal of deen is a great value in eyes of Allah. But we need to understand the value. A lady came to us, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, and said, if it was permissible for me to show you my face, I would have showed you how beautiful, how pretty I am. I cannot understand why my husband wants to get a second wife. I cannot understand why my husband wants to get a second wife. The Sheikh fainted. Murids came, got regained consciousness. Sheikh, what's wrong? He said, the statement of this woman had made me lose consciousness. A ordinary makhluk of Allah cannot manage and maintain that her husband wants to get a second wife. She is not ready to share her husband. Yet in our hearts we have ghayrullah. How do you think Allah feels? So Allah has given us iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us Islam. Allah has given us all these bounties. But have we valued it? This time, they say three friends met. Wealth, knowledge and time. When they were departing, they said, let's get particulars about each other. Wealth, where will you find you? He said, you will find me in the vaults of the banks and the rich people. Knowledge, where will you find you? No, you'll find me in the books and in the libraries. Time, where will you find you? My friends, If you want to meet me, now is the time. When I leave, there's no place to find me. If I'm gone, I'm gone. This Ramadan, this Laylatul Qadr, this life, this breath that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, at any given time, we can lose it. So we have to make qadr of this year, these opportunities. We know at one time, iman is volatile. We don't know our future. We don't know our destiny. So we need to be prepared in accordingly. We were in one place, one of our friends, we were discussing the topic. So he said, I am not a one to be caught by a woman. I'll never fall for a woman. It's not my weakness. So I told him, I said, I warned him, I said, never say never. So anyway, a few months passed afterwards. When we met him again, he was very stressed, parishan, he had a lot of problems. I said, what happened? So he said, one day his niece asked him for a favor to give her a lift. So he was married, he had one son, they were happily married, mashallah, no issues at all. That one day he decided to give his niece a lift. She said, fetch my friend. He said, I went to fetch her. She got into the back seat of the car. As I turned around and I looked at her, he said, as she got in, she looked her hair, she waved her head. She turned towards me and smiled. He said, I was gone. I was gone. His whole life in turmoil. His wife got divorced. He lost custody of his child. He lost his job, etc., etc. A father was searching the clothing of his son who was a drug addict, and he found one pouch. He said, let me try it. I don't know what this youngster goes crazy over. They say the father tried it. He became an addict. He became the addict. So these are Mubarak nights. People are saying, what ibadah should we do? Besides tilawat, long rakats of salah, amal, etc. We can also do other things. One is work out our qazai umri. How much salat do have I missed my entire life? And make a niyyah to complete it. If a person starts and they pass away, we have hope from Allah. Allah will resurrect him amongst those that have completed it. But at least we need to start. Like a hafiz who makes niyyah to start hifz. He starts his hifz. He passes away and he just learned one surah. We have hope Allah will resurrect him from the huffaz. Likewise, our worlds. We see there's a lot of issues nowadays. Who owns what? Does the husband own what? The wife owns what? Etc. The assets, we need to stipulate. When we got married, who owned this? Who owned this? Is it dual partnership? We have certain accounts, certain offshore accounts. Those details, the passwords, etc. need to be placed somewhere safely. The information needs to be made available. Debtors, creditors. So our worlds, we shouldn't sleep if our world not is not in order. If on these nights we are busy sorting out our worlds, we get in reward of ibadah. Likewise, surahs. When's the last time I learned surahs? Do I know Amma Para at least so I can read long tilawat in salah? Adiyah, there's so much adiyah to learn. That is all ibadah. Al-faqihun wahidun ashadu ala shaitan min alfi abid. One scholar who's sleeping is more beneficial and better than 1,000 abids, worshippers who are making ibadah the whole night. Why? Because he knows the masail, how to maximize on akhirat. Spend some time learning masail. Another ila al-Kaaba ibadah. Looking at the Kaaba is ibadah. Another ila wajil walidain ibadah. Let us look at our parents. We are getting ibadah. Who I need to forgive? Who I need to ask for forgiveness? All these issues we are fighting every day. We were deprived of this night of Laylatul Qadr because of the argument of Sahaba. Likewise, we are fighting, we take people to us for nothing, we don't listen to the other side of the story. All these things, our life is too short. We shouldn't be getting into that. Al-mu'minu mir'atul mu'min. A believer is a mirror for a believer. So I should be seeing that any fault in anybody else is a fault of myself. I should be reflecting. There was a mother who was busy in a garden. Her 8-year-old son came in and said, oh, Ami, Yusuf has taken crayons and scribble on the new wallpaper. So I told him he's going to be in very big trouble. So the mother rushed into the house and asked, where is he, where is he? And he was hiding in a closet. As children, when they get in trouble, they hide away. So she went to the closet, she scolded him, and she said, this is my new wallpaper. She gave him a beating. Then she went to the place where he had scribbled on. And inside a heart, he wrote, My ummi, I love you. They say the mother left that. She put an empty picture frame around it to remind her forever that next time, take time to read the handwriting. Sometimes the people who love us most and have sacrificed for us most, we affect them most. So these are Mubarak Ayyam and Layali. Allahumma innaka afoon rahimun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna ya kareem. We should be reading that dua all the time. The dua for today is Allahumma inni asbahtu ushiduka wa ushidu hamlata arshik wa malaikatak wa jami'a khalqik. إنك أنت لا إله إلا أنت وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك. Whoever says this once, أعتق الله ربعه من النار. One quarter of his body is made free, protected from the fire of Jahannam. Second time, half. Third time, three quarter. Fourth time, Allah سبحانه وتعالى أعتقه الله من النار. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will free him from the fire of Jahannam. Continuing with the fadail of tahajjud, Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent wahi to Yahya alayhi salatu wassalam. One night he overate and overslept. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَدْتَ دَارٌ خَيْرًا مِّن دَارِي. Oh Yahya, have you found a house better than my house? هَلْ وَجَدْتَ جِوَارًا خَيْرًا مِّن جِوَارِي. A neighbor better than me. وَعِزِّي وَجَلَالِ لَوِطَّلَعْتَ إِلَى الْفِرْدَوْسِ. If you had seen what Jannah had in Jannah al-Firdaus, لَذَابَ جِسْمُكْ. Your body would have melted. وَذَهَبَتْ نَفْسُكَ إِشْتِيَاقًا. And your ruh would have left you in shock of Jannah. وَلَوِ اتَّلَعْتَ إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمْ. And you were privy to Jahannam. لَذَابَ جِسْمُكَ. Your body would have melted. وَلَبَكَيْتَ السَّدِيدَ بَعْدَ الدُّمُو. You would have cried tears, then tears of blood. And you would have cried even tears of pus if you knew what was in Jahannam. Asad bin Mughis used to say that I seen a beautiful lady, I've never seen her ever. And I asked her, Man anti? Faqalat al hawra, amongst the hurs of Jannah. So I said, marry me. She said, give me a proposal and a mahar. I said, what's the mahar? Qalat tulut tahajjud. Spend time, long rakats in salat, reading it. Ibn Rabi' is the daughter of Rabi', she stay. Ya abati mali aran nas yanamuna wa araka la tanam. I see you awake the entire night, everybody's sleeping. So he said, ya bnatah, oh my daughter, inna abaki yakhafu nar. The problem is I fear Jahannam, and the fear of Jahannam has made me lose my sleep. Rabi' said, I came to waste and I came to inspect and see what was his ma'amul. So he said, he read Fajr Salat, then he sat. And I said, I will remain with him. Then he sat making ibadat in amal until dhuhr. Then he read dhuhr salat. Then he carried tal asr. Then he made ibadat tal maghrib. Then he remained in the same place and he made ibadat tal isha. Thumma thabata makanu hatta salat al fajr. Tal fajr he was busy in amal and ibadat. Then after that, faghalabathu aynahu. Some slumber overwhelmed him. And he said this dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min aynin nawwama. Oh Allah, I seek refuge from an eye that falls asleep. Wa min batnin la tashba', and from a stomach that does not get satisfied. Fakultu hasbi hadha minhu. I said, this is ways. That's why he's got such great rewards. Ahmed ibn Harbi used to say, Ya ajaman liman ya'lamu anna al-jannah. Strange, a person knows Jannat is been beautified above him. وَأَنَّ النَّارُ تُسَعَّرُ تَحْتَهُ. Jahannam is being ignited below him. كَيْفَ يَنَامُ بَيْنَهُمَا. Yet he has the guts to sleep between the two. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.